African students make up 1 in every 10 who are traveling overseas to gain an education. I think it's exceptionally important to spend at least some time elsewhere, out of your own country, learning different approaches to the discipline and new techniques.
Among my generations, we were 5 to go abroad, and I was the only one who has come back.
A good question might be, why don't graduates return to the country?
If you leave, especially without a position to come back to, it can be a challenge to come back and get a position.
The fear of finding jobs after when you come back, and the salary, because you think that you have made 3 years more than the others, so you think that you have to be paid more.
There are 2 moments where someone from the diaspora who has a PhD can return, just when he gets his PhD. So then it's easy for that person to return, or 20 years later, when the kids are out of the house.
When I finished my PhD, I was stranded. I couldn't join my department. The guys were just, you would be seen as a baby.
Need to understand what you have been studying abroad. I got my PhD in 97 in density functional theory. How many people in Africa could understand what I had studied and what was the value of that?
Great opportunities are open to them that I think aren't always visible when you're abroad. And the one way of keeping them visible is by collaborating, to keep the collaborations going between those who are abroad, because then they see the opportunities and can seize them to come back.